terms of position. The first term is anterior. Anterior mean in front. In front. Or near the front of the body. This is called this direction, which is anterior, is means in front or near the front of the body. The same is ventral. Anterior equal to ventral. The ventral aspect of the body is the same as the anterior aspect of the body. And the term ventral is actually derived from the fetal position. This position. Anything in the fetus during intrauterine fetal life toward the face, toward the umbilicus, toward the anterior abdominal wall is called anterior or ventral. In the fetus, it is called ventral. In adult lives after delivery, it's called anterior. Anything in the fetus toward his back is called dorsal. Therefore, anything toward the face and towards the umbilicus is ventral. Anything towards the back of the fetus is called dorsal. And anterior means in front or near the front and equal to ventral. The contrast of anterior or ventral is towards the back or near the back of the body. Near the back or towards the back of the body is called posterior, or in relation to the body of the fetus, it is called also dorsal. Therefore, anterior means the front or near to the front. Anterior equal ventral. Posterior equal dorsal, which mean behind or near to the back of the body. There are also posterior, dorsal, and there is also retro. If you hear retro, example retro peritoneal structure, retro means posterior, that this structure is posterior to the peritoneum. Therefore, retro is also equal to dorsal, equal to posterior. There is two contrast terms, superior and inferior. First of all, superior, which equal to upper, equal to cranial. All this superior, upper cranial mean near the upper end of the body. Upper means upward. Superior means upward toward the upper end of the body. What is cranial? Cranial is the skull, towards the skull, which is the upper end of the body. And this also derived from the fetal position. In the fetal position during intrauterine fetal life, anything towards the skull is called the cranial. Anything away from the skull, towards the gluteal region and towards the lower limb, is called caudal. This is superior upper cranial, means upward, near the upper end of the body. The contrast is inferior, lower caudal. Anything caudal towards the lower end of the body. means lower, towards the lower part of the body, means inferior, towards the lower part of the body. Therefore, we have two contrast, superior, upper, cranial. In contrast, inferior, lower, caudal. There are two contrast terms also, medial and lateral. Medial means toward the middle line. Medial, near or towards the middle line. Lateral is away from the middle line. Medial, near the middle line. Lateral, away from the middle line. And we know in the previous video, median. Median is exactly in the middle line. We have two contrast terms used in the limbs, in upper and lower limbs. Proximal and distal. Proximal mean near the root of the limb or near the trunk, while distal means away from the root of the limb or away from the trunk. Therefore, proximal, nearer to the root of the limb and the trunk. Distal, away from the root of the limb and the trunk. In the limbs in lower and in the upper limb, proximal or distal. There are two contrast terms, superficial and deep. Superficial toward the surface of the body. And on the surface of the body there is the skin. Therefore, towards the surface, towards the skin is superficial, while away from the skin, away from the surface of the body, inside the body, is deep. There are also two contrasts, external or outer. Near the surface of the body or on the surface of the body is external or outer. External or outer means superficial, towards the surface of the body. Internal or inner. Internal or inner means inside the body. Inside the body and also deep. Therefore, superficial, external or outer can be used in the same way. Deep or internal or inner can be used in the same way. If you hear berry, berry is a term used for anything around a structure. Anything around a structure. Berry means around. In contrast, endo. Endo is inside the structure or lining the structure. Like endosium lines the medulla. Endothelium. Endothelium lines the blood vessels. Therefore, endo means inside or lining a structure. Bara. Bara like bara, medium plane. Bara means beside. Enter. Enter means in between. If a structure passes between two structures, it is called enter. Epi and and sup are the contrast. Ab means just above a structure. Sub means just below a structure. Two contrast terms, supra and infra. Supra means the most superior structure, while infra means the most inferior structure. Let us take examples for these terms. This is the chest. This bone is called the sternum. And behind the sternum, this is the heart. These are the ribs. And this reddish color is the lung. The sternum, tell me, what is the relation of sternum to the heart? The sternum is anterior to the heart or posterior to the heart? The sternum is towards the front, more near to the front. Therefore, it is anterior to the heart. While the heart is more towards the back, away from the front, in relation to the sternum. Therefore, the heart is posterior to the sternum. Towards the middle line, towards the anterior aspect is sternum, anterior. Away from the front, towards the back is the heart. The heart is posterior to the sternum. And trachea. Trachea, and this is the apex of the lung. The trachea is towards the middle line or in the middle line, medial to the lungs, which are away from the middle line. Therefore, the lungs are lateral in relation to the trachea. This cut section, this is a transverse section in the upper abdomen. This structure is the stomach. This structure is the pancreas, blood vessels. It is not our concern is the name of this blood vessel. These are blood vessels, left kidney, right kidney, and the spleen. What is the relation of the stomach to the pancreas? The stomach is toward the front of the body. Therefore, the stomach is anterior, while the pancreas is towards the posterior abdominal wall. These are the muscles of the posterior abdominal wall, and this is the vertebra. Therefore, the pancreas is posterior, while the stomach is anterior. Is the pancreas always posterior? No. What is the relation of pancreas to these blood vessels? The pancreas toward the anterior aspect, towards the front of the body. Therefore, the pancreas is anterior. While the blood vessels near the back of the body, therefore, the blood vessels are posterior to the pancreas, while the pancreas is anterior to these blood vessels. What is the relation of pancreas to the left kidney? Pancreas toward the front of the body, anterior, and the left kidney towards the back of the body, posterior. Okay, these are examples for the relation. We notice that this is the kidney, surrounded by fat. Fat around the kidney. This fat is called perirenal fat. Renal means kidney. Therefore, fat around the kidney, perirenal fat. These are examples for the anatomical terms. Let us also take superficial or deep. This is the surface of the body, skin and subcutaneous fat, superficial. While all these organs inside the body are deep, the skin and superficial fascia and this fat and this muscle are external. The same is superficial or external, and all these organs are deep and internal in the same time. Can be described as internal structures or deep structures. These are examples for the terms of position. Let us take finally terms of number. Terms of number, if you hear uni or mono, this means one. As mono, this cell is called monocyte. Monocyte because it is mono. Large, the largest cell in the immune system, because it is the largest cell and have a single one nucleus, therefore it's called mono, means mono, means single, one nucleus, one large cell, the largest cell in the immune system. By or die, by B or die by D means two. The most famous is this muscle, which has two heads, therefore it's called the bi. Bi means two heads, biceps. Tri means three. This is the most famous muscle formed of 1, 2, 3 parts. What are this muscle which formed of 1, 2, 3 heads? Triceps. In the back of the arm. Quadri means four. The most famous is quadriceps, muscle with four parts, four heads. Four parts, quadriceps. Multi or poly. Multi or poly means many, 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 like this muscle, which is formed of many, 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 many parts. Therefore, it is called multifidus, multifidus muscle. Multi or poly, in contrast to this is oligo. Oligo means little. Little like what? The most famous is oligospermia. If we count the sperms and we found that the sperm count is low than normal, little than normal, it's called oligospermia. These are the terms of number and terms of position. Thank you for good listening and good luck.